Hey, what's up? My name is Adam, and in this video, I'm going to share a mind mapping organizer template that works with Notion. So if you want to get the template, first off, you don't really have to watch this video. If you don't want to, you can just head over down in the description of this video, click the first link you see to Gumroad, which is like a store for digital products. And from there, you can just get the template and add it to your ecosystem. So yeah, if you want to do that, feel free to go grab it. If you want to watch the video and follow along, also cool. In this video, I'll be talking about the underlying rationale for the template, some of the features, walking through what it is, how you can customize it. I'll walk through an example of how I started with the template and actually evolved my workflow to kind of specialize. So it really is just a starting point for me to work off of and a place to have all of your content. And then I'll explain how to take the template and embed it into Notion workspaces. I am a Notion user myself. I love it. I think it's great as an infinite canvas for all of my different processes and categories and things that I'm working on. So this is a way to kind of take all of the files and documents and like ideas, snippets floating around in my mind for a specific process or project or topic, and then just embed it directly into Notion and kind of have that deep pocket of information living within that infinite canvas, if that makes sense. So yeah, let's just dive right into the video. So this is a setup that we created to essentially reduce the cognitive load that it takes to organize materials and switch between multiple tabs and files and documents. So as you can see, there's a lot of information in here. This is one example of a PDF. There's another one here for a completely different topic on, you know, economics. Just goes to show that you can really customize this entire template however you want. And there's directions here about our best practices for using it. So how to duplicate it and make it a part of your ecosystem, how to upload files, which is actually just clicking this button. And then, yeah, there you go. Then how to organize things into folders. And we've actually built out over 50 folders already that have some pre-existing titles to them. So if you feel like changing the folder names, you can totally do that and just make it your own. We don't know exactly what everyone's gonna do with these, quite honestly. It's very interesting to see how everyone will build off of it, but it's meant to have the same organizational elements that will work across different types of assignments, different types of research papers, articles, whatever you're trying to accomplish. The first step is definitely creating a mind map in a sense. So, you know, I've seen a lot of different types of quote unquote mind maps before where you see these webs of topics, but this is more structured. I think like it's more functional. You know, it's great to look at your map of topics that you have, but I think actually being able to see everything in one place and navigate between your things is more important. So this is just an example right here of how I use it. And I've definitely made some tweaks to this version where I'm doing research on the topic of patient centricity. So I'm constantly adding to this hub. And here I've created links between my notes and the actual files that are inside of here. So I don't really have to remember where things are. You know, I just know within my notes, there's embedded resources that make it super easy to navigate and understand the underlying context for each of these topics that I'm researching. And this structure has been adapted for all of my different notes. And I can kind of, you know, move them around, switch them up, and make sure that this thing is evolving to meet my needs. And if you're here because you're interested in Notion templates, this definitely integrates into Notion. So I'll show you what that looks like. Whenever you take like a hub here, for example, you can access the link. And then once you copy the link and you just kind of embed it into Notion workspace, you'll be able to have the hub just pop up like this. So this is an example of a different hub. I'm using this to gather requirements for the product, like how to improve this actual user interface for you. So if you have any feedback, I would definitely input it into this hub, just so you know. But ultimately, yeah, I use Notion a lot. I love Notion. I think of it as an infinite canvas. So I have all of my processes that I use here on a regular basis mapped out, organized, and categorized. So, you know, I'll use my processes like in hub format for marketing, sales, technical, etc. And whenever I click any of these, I open it up and it actually becomes an embedded hub. So I have a hub for every single process that I do, and it just loads within Notion. And yeah, it's just taking a little bit of time here because I'm literally streaming and recording with all of my bandwidth right now. But yeah, as you can see, the hub just pops up and it makes it really cool as a mind mapping tool in that you can just have an overarching Notion workspace of all of your different processes or all of your different topics, you know, whatever categories you want. And then within it, you can embed these really deep, powerful hubs of files and information. If you're on the Notion free plan, you're probably aware of the attachment file size limit of 5 megabytes. So this is also a pretty interesting hack to use where you can upload bigger PDFs and documents into a hub and then embed it into Notion. So you'll still be able to actually use those big files in Notion and not have to deal with that storage limit. Yeah, so in order to get the template, just to remind you, go to the link in the description of this video. There's a Gumroad link that you can just click and it'll actually bring you to this little web page here. Actually, no, this is my behind the scenes Gumroad. Let me see if I can go directly to the link. Yeah, we'll go. It'll bring you to this page here. You know, has some more information about the template. You can basically just plug in the number 0 here and say, I want this. And from there, you'll just have to give an email. And like after that, you'll get an invitation to go access it. The way you use it is the same as a Notion template where you'll fork it or duplicate it. So you'll get a view only version, which is going to be this right here. And from there, you'll be able to just duplicate it and make it your own and start customizing and making edits to it. Just a couple of things I wanted to mention before closing out this video. If you're not familiar with Kahana as a tool or a platform, it's completely free to use. So you don't need to like input any credit card information or pay. It's just free. It's not a free trial. So yeah, you can just use it for free, which I think is a big benefit for students for sure. That's something I wish I had when I was like in college or university. Then you can also have unlimited collaboration. So you can invite as many guests as you want, no limits. You can upload as many files as you want. There's not like a 50 file limit or something in here. You can just do as many as you want. And then you can use this across all of your devices. So your phone, your tablet, your computer, your friend's computer, you know, whatever device, it's just, it'll work because it's browser based and it works on all the popular browsers like Safari, Google, Chrome, etc. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Just a, yeah. It works with Notion, works with Grammarly. So if you have Grammarly installed, you can just use it within the note-taking process. And yeah, ultimately, just wanted to make you aware of this concept of being able to have all of your documents in one place and basically set it up in a way where it mirrors your mind so you don't have to spend so much time like finding your floating docs on your desktop or losing track of things, just kind of keeping everything organized. And yeah, good for hygiene and basically mental health to be able to focus on just one space. So last thing before closing out is just this feature Zen mode, which lets you kind of only look at a single, like only the hub or only this area, this space. So if you have a lot of like other things running along, you can just kind of make it easier on yourself and reduce some distractions. But yeah, if you like this video, feel free to like the video on YouTube and subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell notification for our channel because we'll be dropping more templates and taking people's feedback and trying to build new ones that are really helpful. So we're just getting started with a lot of these things. We'll be building more that we'll be giving to you. And then you can try and use. And if you have ideas, we'd love to hear them. So any questions or ideas for future videos or future products that we can make, like free templates, just definitely head over to the comments and share them. It really helps the channel grow and it helps start like an open collaborative discussion, because ultimately at Kahana, all we really care about is saving time and energy and doing things in an efficient way. We're really just focused on the actual analysis of content, and we like making progress on deep work. And, you know, we're trying to build an ecosystem of templates between Kahana and Notion and Gumroad that will let people kind of create their own ecosystem and pick and choose things that can be adapted to their own workflows. You know, like if you have your own workflow, there's no need to just uproot it for this. Keep doing what you're doing. We only wanted to make this video and share it because it could potentially enhance or be complementary to what you're already doing. So yeah, if you have any questions, just let me know, and hope you have a great rest of your day. Bye.